Welcome, Mathematics 6 Standard, Part 2, Practical Geometry, Chapter 14, Method of Ruler and Compasses, Part 11, Method of Ruler and the Compass, as is the preferred practice in geometry. It is the most famous method. The dropping of a perpendicular can be achieved through the ruler and the compass's construction as follows. Step 1, given a point P on a line L, like this, L line is given, point P is given. Then step 2, with P as a center, keeping P as a center, a convenient radius, construct the arc intersecting the line L, two points A and B. You draw this arc with the help of the compass. Next step is, with A and B as centers, radius greater than AP, okay, radius greater than AP, draw the two arcs, one for keeping the one needle point on A, draw this arc and again take this with the same length, draw this another arc from the point P. Okay, you will get intersection point. Then, with the help of the scale, then join PQ. Then PQ is perpendicular to L. Join with the help of the scale, join PQ. PQ is perpendicular to the line L. This is how you construct with the help of the compass. Let's see how can we do this. See, this is a line L and point P are given. Now, with help of the compass, on keeping on point P, I draw a arc which is intersecting the line L. See, like this, intersecting at point A and point B, like this. And take your compass, and it should be more than radius. Length should be more than your PB or AP. See, more than PB it is, BP it is. Now draw an arc here, keeping at the point B, and another point needle keeping on A. Draw the other arc which will intersect the first arc. Like this, you get the point there, point Q. Point Q you get here, like this. Join QP. This will be perpendicular to the line L. So it is exactly 90 degrees. Without using a protractor, you draw the line exactly 90 degrees at the angle of 90 degrees. Please subscribe my channel, hit the bell icon and save the playlist. Thank you very much. Bye bye.